Burnout is the plague that has been rotting longtime Warframe players for years now. The first few days feels a blast, but once you grinded for so long, completed all the quests, gathered all the items you want to try, the game feels repetitive, and you will feel depressed to the point that playing Warframe becomes stressful. That is why I always advise players to take breaks and don't just live in Breath Warframe every day. There are lots of content for new players, but it would be a repetitive choir if you will just play the game because of that stigma of fear of missing out. In fact, getting back to the game after a few weeks or months of hiatus gets you in a trance, then ask yourself if Warframe is even worth playing after seeing almost everything that the game has to offer for decades. And it feels like you know what to expect every update, that you are not excited anymore and jumping back to the game you love. This has happened to me a couple of times, and that is why it's always a breath of fresh air whenever I played something new while waiting for new content in Warframe. I got rid of that stigma where I must play the game because I don't want to miss out on something. I play Warframe now because I want to play something that I enjoy in the game. This leads me to the new update called Koumei and the Five Fates, which was really an unexpected update for me. The update did not receive any huge attention, and in fact, I was too busy playing the first Descendant in Space Marine 2 when Digital Extremes announced that they'll be revealing their new update in the Tokyo Game Show this year. The main focus of the update is Koumei, the new Warframe, but there was really no hype done behind the Warframe, and Digital Extremes revealed just bits of information saying that she will be themed as a Dice Maiden. So when the update arrives, I decided to make testing the new Warframe as my top priority, and during my first few hours, I honestly enjoy playing Koumei and her unique luck mechanics, but some players beg to differ, and they say that Koumei is not a good Warframe and needs a rework immediately. I think that she needs a couple of changes, but I totally disagree that she needs a complete rework. The reality is, just because a Warframe can't nuke a room or one-shot everything with one cast, doesn't mean that the Warframe is bad. We are so spoiled with nuke metas that we tend to forget how to enjoy a Warframe differently. You see, Koumei is not perfect, and she does in fact need a couple of changes. First of all, the challenges should be made easier so the Warframe can be efficient in a fast-paced game like Warframe. There are instances wherein you will need a couple of minutes just to finish the challenges on her second ability. Don't get me wrong, the challenges are not that hard, but it's not cool, especially when you have to wait for 150 seconds cooldown once you have unlocked the 8 decrees on her second ability. The wait timer is really not fun, and the challenges makes it worse, as it would take a couple of minutes to complete it, especially if you are with a team. I know that Digital Extremes made some changes that ally kills will work for the challenges, and any kills made by squad mates, if the final killing blow is dealt within 2 seconds of Koumei dealing damage to the target, will now count for the requirements in the challenges. This is a good idea to combat the need to exert too much effort when you are with a nuking squad, and you can just spam your first ability to damage enemies, so they will count as your kill for the challenges too, once your team kills it. However, this doesn't work every time, as there are cases wherein players move from one room to another, melting all enemies and leaving nothing for you to kill. You can ask them not to kill enemies, but it's dumb stopping someone enjoying the game how they want to play. Koumei is great in Omnia Fissures, and you can enjoy this Warframe fully in these types of endurance runs, as the more you stay in the mission, the better the Warframe gets with all the decrees she can acquire. However, the 150 seconds cooldown after the 8 decrees and the challenges makes it hard to fully enjoy the luck mechanic of the Warframe on her second ability. I think Digital Extremes are being too conservative with the decree system on Koumei, and they are scared of making the Warframe overpowered. I honestly think that the developers should make the acquisition of decrees easier, as it's also dependent on luck, and they are implementing too much RNG on the skills of the Warframe. The decree you get is random, then you will need to also be lucky to inflict the status needed to complete a challenge while using your first ability. There's always the option to mod for toxin, electric, heat, and cold, which are the most common elements in the challenges, and then rarely physical damage. You can put these damage types in your weapons and companion weapons, but it feels weird, as you all know that most of these elements combine with other single element mods in your build. Corrosive will be great, as you can combine it with heat or cold, but what if you are facing other factions in the game that aren't weak against this damage types? Also, I would also like to talk about the headshot challenge for her second ability. This should be turned into weak spots and not just headshots, as I think Digital Extremes know that they have murmur enemies in the game. If they will make the challenges easier and then cut down the long cooldown, then the Warframe will get better and many will be interested in playing her missions. You see, Koumei is not a meta Warframe that can be universally good in all missions. She is more of a specialist, and she excels and is super fun to use in Omnia Fissure missions. At the very start of the video, we start talking about burnout and all that shit. And honestly, I experienced this in Warframe for several years, that I needed to step away sometimes from the game and play another, so I would not end up hating Warframe and its grind. After months of hiatus playing the game, there are instances wherein I feel like closing the game because I know what I'll be getting into, and while the new stuff is great, but they end up being the same thing and not even game changing, which makes makes me decide to play the game for a couple of months before I start playing another game again. However, the recent update is different and unexpected, as it makes me love playing Warframe again because it feels rewarding, and it's something nostalgic because I did not realize that I am enjoying the game just like how I did during my early years of playing Warframe. You see, one of the best missions that I really enjoy in Warframe is survival missions, because it highlights the good thing about horde shooter games, wherein you earn lots of rewards and it challenges your builds at the same time. Well, there's no point in doing the mission for long hours as it has the same rewards, but it's really fun and Koumei makes survival runs, especially the new Amia Fissure is both enjoyable and rewarding for me. The Amia Fissures that includes Alchemy Conjunction Survival and Normal Survival Mode are the missions wherein it felt like it's the playground for the new Warframe. Not only that you enjoy playing the game modes for the rewards, but I'm actually enjoying and looking forward on doing the challenges and excited on what decree I get next. At the same time, the Warframe gets powerful on every decree she gained. However, just like I have said before, there are instances wherein it feels like it's taking you an eternity to get a decree since everyone else are killing enemies fast, and you don't even have the chance to inflict status to targets since the kill speed of your squad mates are way faster. This is the only complaint I have about Koumei, and I'm hoping that Digital Extremes get rid of the limiter in getting decrees. I really am thankful though that Koumei was created, because it renewed my love of playing Warframe. I've been doing content creation in this game for years, and it felt like I was teleported back when I truly enjoyed doing survival runs. Then this enjoyment gets rewarded with loot such as prime parts, endo, and then prime junks, which I can use and sell to other players for platinum. In fact, this week, after doing the weekly missions in Warframe, all I did was all Omnia Fissures with Koumei, and all those times spent doing this in Warframe gets rewarded this weekend when I have started trading all the stuff I have farmed from Omnia Fissures for platinum. Just a quick tip though, Omnia Fissure Void Cascade is not a good fit for Koumei though, as there are fewer enemy spawns compared to the other Omnia Fissure missions. If you are doing the mission in public matches, then you might end up with a nuking team that will be wiped out enemies instantly, and you won't even get enough decrees before the levels of enemies scale higher. So that's all about it. Overall, I really love playing Koumei, and this might not be for all, but I hope that players understand that a Warframe is not bad if it's not nuking everything in seconds. There are also Warframes that are considered specialist, and they are enjoyed best in specific missions, just like Koumei. Try it out in Omnia Fissures, and you will see what I'm talking about. All I'm hoping is that you will see how enjoyable the Warframe is, and if you like this video and find it useful in some way, then please do like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching, and we hope to see you again in our next Warframe guide.
Excellent armaments, operator. Please return
covered in blood.
Safe and sound.